In last lecture, we have studied the number system. Shortly, again, we will see the numbers. Firstly, natural number. Natural number generally denoted by n letters. This starts from 1, 2, 3 up to the so on. Next, that is whole number, that is w, starting from 0, 1, 2 up to the so on. Next, integer generally denoted by z. This is a 0, 1, 2, 3, plus so on, here minus 1, minus 2 up to the here, minus infinity, here plus infinity. After that, we already know that even number, that is 2, 4, 6, 8. Odd number is a 1, 3, 5, 7. Prime number is the number which is divisible by 1 and itself. That number is said to be prime number. We'll see the example, that is 2, 3, 5 in that way. After that, the biggest set of that all number, that is the real number. Real number, it contains all numbers. Which all numbers? Natural number, whole number, integers, prime, odd number, even number, rational number. Rational number, we know that of the form p by q, where p and q are the integers. Rational, irrational numbers, all numbers. The biggest set on the real line is the R. R means what? Real numbers. This is the biggest set. So, we will see the how to create a real line. So, this is the first 0. Here 1. Here 2. Here 3. Suppose here is minus 1. Here minus 2. Here minus 3. So 1, 2, 3, 4 are the natural numbers. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 are the whole number. 0 plus minus 1 is 0 plus minus 2, 0 plus minus 3. These are all the integers. So, where is the odd number? These 2, 4 are the even number. 1, 3, these are the odd numbers. Where is the rational and irrational numbers? We know that rational numbers of the form p by q. Q is not equal to 0. P and q are the prime. For example, see here. Suppose you take the 2 by 3. Its answer is 0 point something. 0 point something, it is in between 0 and 1. So, suppose here something. If you taking the next example as like 3 by 2, its answer is the 1 point something. Here 1 and 2. This number is in between 1 and 2. Means what? This is a very important theorem. Remember that in between two integers. Repeat again once more. So, in between two integers, there are so many rational as well as irrational numbers. You can take in between positive or you can take in between negative. Take any two integers. Suppose 0 to minus 1 or 1 to 2 or 0 to 1. In that, there are infinite numbers of rational as well as irrational. We will see about the irrational numbers. For example, if you can take under root of 2, this is an irrational number. Its answer is 1.4 something. 1.4 is where in between 1 to 2. Means what? There is in gap in between 1 to 2. That gap means what? In that two numbers, there are so many infinite numbers of rational as well as irrational numbers. You can take any two numbers, 1 to 2 or 2 to 3 or 3 to 4. Same way, you can take 0 to minus 1, minus 1 to minus 2. That gap contains, there are infinite numbers of rational and irrational. So, with the help of that, this created a line. And that line is called as the real line. So, same way, this is the real line. Suppose here numbers is the 0, here 1, here 2, here 3, here minus 1, here minus 2, here minus 3. So, we will draw same line as like this. This is a horizontal line. We will draw vertical line, and that vertical line is called as the imaginary line That number is also in the form of real. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here -1, -2, -3. So this is called as the real line is called as the x-axis, and this imaginary line is called as the y-axis. So combination of this x and y, that number is called as the complex number. So in order pair, so this is a representation of complex number. In order pair, first number is on the x-axis and second number is on the y-axis. Complex number is denoted by z is equal to in the form of x plus iy. X means what? On the number which is on the x-axis. Y means what? Number which is on the y-axis. So first, this is a in order pair, first number is on the x-axis, which is in the form of positive, and second number that is on the y-axis, this is also positive. So first, this is called as the first quadrant. This is called as the second quadrant. So here x number is negative, y number is positive, hence here plus plus or here minus plus. What about 3? This is the third quadrant. Here number of x-axis is in the form of negative, number is of the y in the form of also negative. Here negative, negative. What about the fourth quadrant? Fourth quadrant of the form x in the form of positive and y of the form in the form of negative. So this is the fourth quadrant. First is the plus plus, second is minus plus, third is minus minus, and fourth is the plus minus. So general form of complex number is z is equal to x plus iy. So we'll see some explanation about the complex number. So after that, real number, that is R. R is a biggest set. Remember that it is a biggest set. I will take detail one lecture on the set. Before that, remember that set R is the biggest set on the real line. But C is also set which is the superset of R. R is the subset of complex number C. So this is the symbol of subset. R is a subset of complex number C. So complex number of the form z is equal to x plus iy. I means what? I means under root of minus 1. I square means what? Under root of minus 1 into under root of 1. That is, its value is 1. Also, complex number, its mod. Mod of that complex number z can be written as under root of x square plus under root of y square. After that, we will see the sum graphs on the both plane x and y axis. So draw the line y is equal to x. So this is the x axis, this is the y axis. Here take some number 1, 2, 3, here -1, -2, -3, here 1, 2, 3, here 4, -1, -2, -3, 0. So we'll take the sum numbers. Our line is y is equal to x. How line is passes, we'll see that. Here we'll draw the table x. I'll take some 0 number. Here -1, -2, here some positive number 1, 2, 3. Put this value of x in this, you will get the value of y. The value of x is 0, then value of y is also 0. Value of x is -1, value of y is also -1. Value of x is minus 2. Value of y is also minus 2. Put the value of x is equal to 1 in this equation, then you will get y is equal to 1. Put the value of x is equal to 2 in this equation, y is equal to 2. Put the value of x is equal to 3 in this equation, you will get y is equal to 3. So, we will put this point on this graph. So, value of x is 0, value of y is also 0. Value of x is 1. So, this is the x-axis, this is the y-axis. Value of x is 0, 1. Value of y is also 1. So this point, this coordinates of this point is the 1 comma 1. Next point is value of x is 2. Value of y is also 2. So value of x is 2. Value of y is 2. This point, its coordinate is 2 comma 2. Next, value of x is 3. Value of y is also 3. So this is value of x is 3. Value of y is also 3. So we will take some negative points. Value of x is minus 1. Value of y is also minus 1. This point. Minus 1 comma. First number is on the x axis. Second number is on the y axis. Value of x is minus 2. Value of y is also minus 2. So this point. Value of x. This is on the x axis. This is on the x axis. This is on the y axis. Minus 2 comma minus 2. This is on the minus 3 comma minus 3. So passes the line from this point, we will pass this line from these points. So this is the straight line which is passing from, this is the first quadrant and this is the third quadrant. So this is a graph of the line y is equal to x. You can take any points, no problem. Here is some positive points, some negative points and zero. With the help of that, you can guess how to line pass from this and how to line passes from this graph. So here, remember that the power of y is 1 and power of x is also 1. In that case, this line may be in the form of straight line. So we'll see the next diagram. That is, second example, y is equal to minus x. Draw the line y is equal to minus x. So here, we'll draw the table firstly. X, y, here take point 0, 1, 2, 3, here negative points minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So, put the value of x is equal to 0, value is also, value of the y is also 0. Put value of x is minus 1, then y is equal to minus 1. Put the value of x is equal to 2, y is equal to minus 2. Value of x is equal to 3, y will get minus 3. Value of x is minus 1, this minus and this minus, it will becomes a plus. Y is equal to 1. This is also 2 and this is the 3. We will draw the diagram. So this is the 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, 0. Here 1, 2, 3, 4. Here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So put this point here, 0, 0. Value of x 0, value of y 0. Means what? Origin. Value of x is 1. Value of y is minus 1. See here, value of, this is a x-axis. This is the y-axis. Value of x is 1. Value of y is minus 1. See here, value of x is 1. Value of y is minus 1. So, here points. Value of x 1 and value of y is minus 1. Value of x is 2. Value of y is minus 2. So, this point. 2 comma minus 2. Value of x is 3. Value of y is minus 3. So these points, these are the coordinates of our lines. Next, value of x is minus 1. Value of y is 1. Value of x is minus 2. Value of y is minus 2. Value of x is minus 3. Value of y is minus. So these are points. So this is the value of minus value of x is minus 1, value of y is 1. Here value of x is minus 2, value of y is 2. Here value of x is minus 3, here value of y is 3. So join these points with the help of line, and this is the line which is passing through second quadrant and this is the fourth quadrant. So this line is the y is equal to minus x. So after that we will see the next line, that is y is equal to third number, y is equal to 2x plus 1. So first we will draw the table x, y, here 0, here 1, 2, 3, here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So put here x is equal to 0, y is equal to 1. X is equal to 1, y is equal to 2 plus 1, that is 3. X is equal to 2, 4 plus 1, that is y is equal to 5. X is equal to 3, 3 into 2, 6, 6 plus 1, 7. Same way, put here value of x, that is minus 1, minus 1, it's minus 2 plus 1, that is minus 1. Put here minus 2, minus 4 plus 1, that is minus 3. Put x is equal to minus 3, that is minus 6 plus 1, minus 5. So this is a table. After that, we will draw its a diagram. So this is the x-axis, this is the y-axis. Value of x is 0, value of x is 0, and value of y is the 1. Here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, here something 5. Here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and here minus 5. So starting from this, value of x is 0 and value of y is 1. So this is the first point. Value of x is the 1, value of y is 3. Value of x is 1, value of y is 3. This is the point. Value of x is 2, value of y is 5. Suppose something here. So these three points, remember that. Next, we'll take negative. Value of x is minus 1, value of y is minus 1. So this point. Value of x is minus 2, value of y is minus 3. Value of x is minus 2, value of y is minus 3. Value of x is minus 3, value of y is minus 5. So see here. So this point. So this is a line. That line is called as a y is equal to 2x plus 1. Means, remember that in previous two graphs, there is no any constant. It means what? That curve passes from in a origin. If there is some constant with addition of that variable, then that line does not pass through the origin. So this is the third examples of y is equal to 2x plus 3. In next lecture, we will see the example as like y is equal to x square, or fifth number x is equal to y square, or try in your home by putting x is equal to some point positive or some point negative. Again here put y is equal to some point positive, some point negative, and 0, then and draw this point, and with the help of that joint point, then we get the line. Thank you.